Okay, check it. I was able to enjoy my my Holy Grail sale for all of about 10 minutes.
Quest for the Holy Grail.
The Junko pants that I found at the flea market I bought for $15. Those sold for $200 almost overnight. It was immediate. We started getting offers. Obviously, starting with the low ballers, came in at 150. I had them listed for two. I think I have to look at the listing again. It's been a little bit. I think I had them for about 280, 299, maybe. I listed them high because I anticipate the low ballers coming in, but it was immediate. Low ballers coming in at 150. Like a day later, 180, and I told Candy, we get an offer for 200, we're taking it, just to move that stuff. I don't want to sit around and holding out for more. And hey man, if we can spread the wealth, then so be it. If this is a collector that bought them, good for you, you got a killer pair of pants. If you're a reseller, maybe you can make another $100 on it, I don't know, but you know, I'm not greedy. I paid $15 for them and found them. They ended up selling for $200. We got an offer for $200. Boom, we took it. They were gone. And then shortly after that, Candy come running in like a bowl in a china shop.
China shop, man. Fuck this shit.
And had to outdo me. It's a good thing we're on the same team. You know, it used to be in football, we'd say, man, I'm glad I'm playing with that guy because I'd hate to play against him. Candy's one of those people. Even though this industry's not competitive.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, yeah, right.
Yeah, right.
Okay. There is still some competitiveness out there, and I'm super competitive anyway by nature. Candy's super competitive, and we keep it light, and we allow it to inject a little levity into this industry and this little side hustle we got going. We have enough going on in our everyday lives with real jobs and you know, our families and everything else that we can't let this thing get out of hand and become a point of contention, I guess it would be. So we allow our competitiveness to be used as a tool of levity, and we have fun with it, and we use it as kind of motivation for us finding the next Grail.
Our quest is to find the Holy Grail.
Yeah.
So I don't really buy into all this Grail thing. I know it keeps everybody on their toes and looking for this and that, and I understand what you guys are talking about the Grails and everything else, but to be honest, there's stuff that we've paid a dollar for that we sold for $40, and that's just as much as a Grail as a $15 pair of pants, and you sell them for $200. So it's all about profit margin, I guess. Candy, in an online auction, bought some little reindeer, and I mean, they couldn't have been much taller than maybe 6 inches and maybe no longer than 4 or 5 inches. And there was two sets. I think she paid $40, pretty close to $40 for each set. So almost, you know, it was like $80 for all four reindeer. Two of those reindeer, yes, we put them on our Etsy page, and they sold within a few weeks. And those sold for $499. And 99 cents. Don't forget your 99 cents. So just an amazing sale by Candy. An amazing find. She really has an eye for like vintage trinkets and collectibles and things like that. So good on her, man. She's got bragging rights right now. But what's funny is, I don't know, maybe a few days later, we were at the Concord Flea Market, and I found a vintage American Toy Company logging truck, and that thing sells for, I think I paid $40 for that, and that thing sells for I've seen sold comps for up to $500. So we'll see how that goes. And I still got my cash register that I paid $7 for that I have listed for $800. I don't think it's going to sell for that much, but it's a beautiful piece. So we'll see what it sells for, and then maybe I can regain the crown. But anyway, check out what we got in this new video.
I look for the stitched ones. I'm gonna get this.
So here you're gonna see the ground is completely wet in the background right before we got to this flea market, and this is the Napa Vallejo flea market. A thunderstorm had come through and just soaked everybody. You'll see tons of items that are just covered in plastic. People were kind of scrambling to get under pop-up deals, the canopies. And so forth, but this particular vendor, we got some really cool stuff. That you'll see a King's hat in there that I'm gonna actually keep for personal use. So I'll give that to my son. There's a baseball glove right there. You can see it barely in the bottom of the screen, and that actually just sold this morning for $69.99. We bought that for $5. And then we picked up some hanging items that were $10 each. So we did pretty well with this vendor here.
Looking, or you do it good? Okay, I think we got 10, 20. Is that 20
That's
there?
20, yeah.
Okay, and then 3 and 28?
Yep.
Yeah, please, if you don't mind. Yeah. Give you these back. I have a bad habit of keeping hangers.
Not a bad habit.
Keeping hangers.
I don't, yeah. I sell them all the time. No hangers.
We have some at home, right?
Yeah, and they don't match, so.
Awesome, thank you.
Was it busy earlier?
It was.
Want this? No?
That's cute though.
Thank you.
Camp. film him, his private property.
It's just for a YouTube channel for garage sales and thrifting and stuff. How much do you want on your sweatshirt?
$10.
Thank you.
babe? 60? These are 10, I think.
She might cut you more of a deal, I don't know. These are Ariat too.
Mm-hmm.
Is this that brand?
Mm-hmm. I don't know how well the jeans do though.
Yeah, that's true.
Have to look at them. Do you want the Ariats?
I don't know how good they are.
Have to comp them.
Yeah. I will.
Here's some trues. Michael Kors.
I think this was her last time.
Sexy couture.
Miss Me Jeans.
Huh?
The Miss Me Jeans. Those are Juicy Couture.
They're sexy couture. These are trues.
I'd rather do Miss Me's. Oh, trues for men are good.
Here's Miss Me.
Yeah. What is that one?
Miss Me. Miss me. Miss me.
I don't know how much those are. Here, I'm going to give you 100.
Are these 10? Or 15 also?
Which one? That one?
Yeah.
35.
35? Oh, I'm good. I have corn in my teeth and I'm trying to get it out. Thank you, though.
Did I sell him?
Oh, that's good.
You see
I saw him.
And oh my God. And I've never seen that face.
Oh.
And if he always with that farmer's bite.
Uh-huh.
And it's really good.
It's like truffles, huh?
Mm-hmm. It's with watermelon side.
Oh, okay.
So good. It's by him.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What was your name again?
Nancy.
Nancy. Just in case I'll put your name in the text you sent.
And then how much for the Ariats?
I give it to you for 20.
20 each? Or 20 for both?
20
each. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna get these.
Okay.
So I got 1, 2, 3, I got 60 off that table. Get out of here, Rain.
I know.
Thank you.
The best. You want a bag?
Think we can stick them in there? Yeah, I'll take one. Just in case that rain decides to come back.
Well, thank you so much for coming.
Thank you. We'll be back next weekend. Good. Hopefully it's not raining.
Hopefully it's not raining.
I'll throw it in there. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day.
You too.
We'll see you later.
You didn't eat my corn?
I didn't. I told you. I ate mine though.
So. How much on your jackets and shirts?
For what?
Like your t-shirts? I think you gave me those for $5 last time.
$5.
I don't want to drop them in the water.
$5, eh?
And how much on your jacket?
$5.
$5?
Yeah. The jacket for this. the lake.
Mm.
That is.
Yeah, that's a nice one.
Very nice.
Small.
Yeah.
On the boots? Look, I tried to steal his hangers too.
Okay, good morning, guys. Let's see, where to start? Sorry, I get the camera going. Bonkers right now. It's Sunday. Hope you guys set your clocks back. By the time you watch this, it won't matter. I'm just trying to get some lighting going on in here. I want to kind of just show you guys yesterday. What did we do? We decided it was Saturday. We had nothing really planned. We were going to go to a Goodwill in Davis, which is not too far from where we live. And somehow we ended up in Sacramento. I don't know. And we hit a thrift store there. But first thing in the morning, my daughter sent me a message and said, "Hey, is this a good deal?" And it was this guitar. This is an Ibanez Geo. I can't double cut away, but I don't remember. It's like a GB something or other. Where'd the little amp go? Oh, there it is. And it had this. So basically, this was the package. Show this to you real quick. So here was the package. Had this little Fender Frontman 10G amp. It's tiny. It's just a little practice amp. That cable, a little dust cloth, and then the guitar. And I think she sent me a message saying he wants $100 for it. And I said, I'd do 50. And she said, would you do 60? I said, yeah, sure, fine. So she bought it. I Venmo'd her the money. So now I have my kids involved in my habit. She's never a good sign. But anyway, do you want to get up there, girl? Come on. No? You waiting? Matilda's waiting for her eggs. We ran out of dog food, so. Are you going to get eggs? You are? Right, she knows the camera's on her. She's kind of ignoring me. Hey, Matilda. All right, fine. From there, we kind of got ready. We rolled up to Davis. So I'll show you guys what we picked up in Davis. This is a Goodwill that was in that's in Davis. It's still there. So let's see. Some of this stuff we posted last night, and there was, okay, so I gotta preface this all anyway, why I was like really excited to do this video today. So in the last video, you saw there was I picked up a pair of Junko pants at the Napa flea market. I paid $15 for those pants, and we sold them already. We had immediate response as soon as I posted it. Of course, all the low ballers came out: $100, $120, $150. So I figure if I just kind of stuck to my guns for a while, and you know, let the waters calm down, that some more rational players would enter. But you know, whatever, when you're getting that kind of response, I sent out a counter offer for $200, and somebody took it. So that pair of pants, $15 Junko pants. They had a little hole in the back of the leg, so they weren't, you know, mint condition. But at any rate, $15 to $200. I like that. So we're gonna go look for some more Junko pants today. But anyway, Candy may have found her own Holy Grail yesterday, and I will show you that here in a second. But right now, I want to show you, this is a Betsy Johnson little purse. It's got the embossed, I guess you would call those embossed. They're raised, they're part of fabric, hearts. Really cute. So that's already listed. And I think there was one other thing that was already listed, but whatever, it doesn't matter. So I kind of got a little discouraged at this Goodwill, just because the prices were high. I wasn't really finding any good brands. Of course, Candy knows more about the brands than I do, so you know, whatever. This kind of a lesson that even though when you're feeling a little bit discouraged and you know you're not sure you're going to find anything at this particular place, kind of keep your head up, because Candy found a bunch of stuff, and then I started kind of digging through and looking. And of course, after selling a $200 pair of Junkos, I had my mind set on a pair of pants. And I found a pair of pants. They just weren't Junkos. So anyway, these were kind of like last things that I found at the Goodwill. This is has the Steamboat Willie Mickey Mouse on the left chest. This is a women's shirt. Has the Disney tag and UT. I'm not sure what that is, so I got to do some more research on it. I have not comped that. It was $5, so I said why not. Also found this mini, patriotic mini. It's on a Disney tag as well. So I have not comped this either, but for $5, why the hell not. It's white. I always have to like double check white garments for stains and stuff. And it's pretty clean. So, and then I found this in the women's skirts. This is a Fervor. I don't know this either. And I tried to comp it there at the Goodwill and really couldn't get any information on it. But it seemed like some comparable things, dresses did pretty well. So it's a really cool pattern. It's got, you know, aircraft and helicopters and stuff like that on it. So, you know, that was $5 as well. That's kind of my price point at Goodwill, what I'm looking at. I mean, you know, we've paid more before, but for that kind of stuff, that's where I'm kind of trying to live. Anyway, found these Rock Revival pants. These are women's Rock Revival Terra skinnies. Paid $14 for those. So I know Candy and I were I was a little confused. We've found Rock Revival, and there's another one, Rock Republic, I think it is, before, and we thought that the Rock Republic were the good ones, and they're not. So now I know. Rock Revival. Okay, moving on. Let's see. I don't know what this is. I couldn't find a tag. Sorry, I'm holding the camera. Oh, this is Cuddle Dad's. Kind of a dry fit, I don't know, athletic top, long sleeve, paid $6 for that. And then Candy found this. I saw it and I was like, nah, not really. It's a little too vintage, but I failed to realize that Candy just sold one of these that we picked up. I think we picked it up at the flea market. I'm not positive where we got it. I'll have to look back and see where we got the last one. The last one we sold was yellow. This one's green. This is a Thule, so I believe that's part of Anthropology. $13.99 paid for that. Candy found these pants. Now there's a brand, but it's crap. But they're fire resistant. So kind of took a chance on those. $9.99, probably break even on those, but. Keep your eye out for anything flame resistant, because it goes pretty well. But, you know, if you can get the Carhartt flame resistant, or, you know, the Dickies, really any name brand that's flame resistant, you're gonna do pretty good on it. Soft surroundings. Sure, I don't even know what the hell to call this. So, but anyway, like I said, Candy knows more about the brands than I do. $6.99 for that one. This is an Express. It's a black skirt and there's no tag on it, which leads me to believe that might not have even been purchased yesterday. It may have just been in a pile. This Burton snow jacket vest, actually kind of a puffer vest. Burton does really well for us. $8 on that. That's a really cool, and we did see a pair of pants there. It's really weird. You can find some labels and styles that you think are going to do really well. I found a pair of Betty Rides, I think it was called, snowboard pants that I was like, oh, cool, these are going to do really good, and started comping them, and they were like $20 they sell for. And they were great-looking pants. They were black with white stripe on the bottom. I mean, just really cool. Female snowboard pants, they don't sell for much, so... Just, you know, if you're not familiar, do your homework, do your comps. Candy got this Levi's. Now this was, okay, I'm kind of moving a little too fast. So that was Goodwill. We decided to roll up to Sacramento and get dessert before we ate dinner. So, you know, hey, we're old enough, we can do that kind of shit. Doesn't matter what we do. We can eat dessert for breakfast if we want. Anyway, and we found this. If you've never been to Midtown Sac, I know it gets... I play a lot of shows in Sac. So I'm pretty familiar with downtown and Midtown. I hesitate to say that it gets a bad rap because it's kind of self-inflicted. The crime in Sacramento is it's bad by normal standards, but it's such a cool town, such a cool city, such a cool downtown area. We were kind of in the Lavender District, which, if you know what the Lavender District is, it's the gay district. the people there are super cool. And it's just, it's alive, man. I mean, we live in a town of 100,000 people. And on Thursday, Friday, Saturdays, it's a good ghost town. It drives me crazy. Sacramento last night was just, there was so much foot traffic and people going to clubs and this and that and the other thing and eating. And there's a record store and a video game store and all of these. There's so many different foods. And then we hit this dessert spot that's all they do is desserts. Well, they do sandwiches too, but that all they've done is for the longest time was desserts, cakes and pies and ice cream and everything else. But it's super cool. If you ever have the chance, if you're in Cali, go downtown, go to Midtown Sac. If you're not from Cali and you're coming up to NorCal, make your way to Midtown Sac or Downtown Sac, because the food, the people there are phenomenal. So it was just cool. We ate at we stopped in and had a slice of pizza at Pizzasaurus Rex, which they were kind of their building was under construction, but off to the side they were still selling slices of pizza and whole pizzas. So, and it was really great pizza. So shout out to Pizzasaurus Rex. Shout out to Rick's Dessert Diner. We had some really good food last night, so thank you. So from there, we found a little thrift store. We've been to this thrift store before. For me, the prices are a little bit high, but if you search, you're going to find some good stuff there. We kind of got there right as they were closing, so we had about 20 minutes to kind of, you know, find some good deals. And Candy found a few things. This Levi's... kind of, I don't know what you would call the lining in this. It's got the fur lining, but it's an extra small. $25 on this Levi's denim with the extra with the fur lining, and where you at? There you go. Let's see. And then she found, what is this guy? This is a Rag and Bone. So $20 on this one, Rag and Bone, women's jacket. It's I don't know, wool, fleece. I don't know what the hell this is. I wish Candy was in here to kind of give me a description, but she's not. So Rag and Bone jacket, that was $20. And then, you know, as we were leaving, I was like, you know, kind of just bitching about the prices and so on and so forth. And Candy kind of dropped on me, hey, check this brand out, because I found something in there that may be her holy grail. You know, I found my Junko jeans, and she automatically has to try and one-up me.
You suck.
Good for her, bad for me. It just means I got to up my game. So... anyway, she found this. I'm going to show you this jacket. It's kind of a blazer. And some of you women out there, women resellers, you probably already know what it is, and you shouted out the brand already. But this is a, whatever that's, La Agency, I guess, maybe. This... we were doing some comps last night. This jacket new is almost $500. Used, I think we were comping well over two, some of them well over $300. So Candy may have found her holy grail and completely blown my holy grail out of the water. So good for her. Just an awesome find. And I think she paid $25 for that. Maybe. I'm not sure. I have to double check with her and see what she paid for that. It wasn't very much. So, you know, $20 to $25 to $300 all day long, we'll take that. All right. So let me catch you up with what sold. I left you with the Dooney and Burke the last time I lived. On the last video, I left you with the Dooney and Burke satchel bag. So let's kind of cruise through a couple of things that sold that are notables. A pair of Nike Jordan 1 Skinny. So we picked these up at the Goodwill in Elkhorn Boulevard, kind of Roseville area. I wasn't sure what these were. I thought maybe they were wrestling shoes or something like that. I've never seen these Nikes before. So we got those for $20.50. They sold for $49.99 plus shipping. Of course, like I said before, I guess I can just dumb it down to now a sale of the week for myself, since it's no longer a Grail. Those are the Junko jeans. Those sold for $200, and you know we picked those up for $15 at the Napa flea market. You know that because I made such a big deal out of it.
You shut the fuck up already.
Anyway, so let's see. Some other stuff that we picked up that sold right away. A pair of ASICS shoes, ASICS Gel Noosa. Multicolored shoes are really cool shoes. Now, in the last video, you probably saw us go and we hit this lady and she had shoes and she was like $5 a pair and we just picked up a whole bunch. So this was another pair of the shoes that we picked up. These sold like overnight. We paid $5 for those and those sold for $39.99. A personal item that Candy had, it's a Yadro. Let's see, this says over the threshold with the box. So again, it was a personal item and that sold for $210. If you guys don't know what a Yadro is, it's very fragile, very breakable, very collectible. So that sold. Let's see here. A pair of the shoes that we got on the last video from the Napa flea market. These are Coach. These weren't as lucrative as I thought they would be, but these are Coach. Usually anything with Coach sells for really good money. These are Coach women's multicolored snow boots. We paid $25 for those and they sold for $34.99, so we didn't lose money, but you know, it wasn't what we thought they were. Let's see here. Okay, something I got on an auction well over a year ago, and I thought they would sell last year since we had just this spectacular winter and everybody was going snowboarding again. I picked up two snowboards and I paid about so this one I paid $26.39. And there was two of them. I don't know, they might have been individual, but anyway, that's what I paid for it. I've had them listed for over a year. And this one sold for $70 plus shipping. Plus shipping, so that made that whole sale into $246.38. Which, you know, whatever. I don't snowboard, but I know they're expensive. I have purchased a snowboard in the past and I know they're expensive, so. Let's see here. We'll move on. And shipping that thing was quite the challenge. Candy and I had to kind of Frankenstein a box and put it together and wrap it in garbage bags and all that stuff. I should have videoed that. That would have been must-see TV. Let's see. A vintage game hide waterproof duck hunter camouflage men's jacket double XL. We've had that for a little while as well. We paid $14.30 for that in an online auction, and that sold for $59.99. Let's see here. A Lucky Brand tote bag that Candy found at a garage sale for $1. That sold for $22. Let's see here. I'm just trying to find the notables here. For no other reason than to impress you. But I'm kidding. This does kind of show the difference in cost of goods and what they sell for and what you can make on some of this stuff. And it really does kind of impress that you do have to find good sales, and you can find things that people are just getting rid of, and they don't want to do the research. They don't want to do the comps. They don't want to sell it on eBay. They just want to get rid of this stuff. So we find it and we sell it for a good profit. Like this Y2K Gap corduroy messenger bag we got for $1 at a garage sale, and that sold for $45. Now, this, like I've said before, Candy is very good at knowing labels and keeping up with the trends and what's selling and everything else. Me, not so much. I'm more of an impulsive buyer. This is a Gap. The brand of this bag is Gap, which normally Gap is something we wouldn't pick up, but the style and the of this bag and the condition of this bag, Candy was like, absolutely, we could sell for good money, and we did. So $1 to $45 has pretty good profit margin. Let's see, pair of the Hokas that we picked up at the Napa flea market the last time. We got those for $20, and those sold for $40, so we doubled our money. Not too bad. Let's see here. Let's find the notables here. The Patagonia backpack that you saw us pick up in the last video. We bought that for $8, and that sold for $54.99. So that was a pretty good pickup. The pair of academic sweats that were in the last video, the black and yellows, we bought those for $15, and those sold for $29.99. I think those may have been picked up at the same time I picked up the Junkos. Both pair of Carhartt overalls that I picked up in the last video, I wrote down here that I paid $5. I didn't. I paid $10 for each pair. This particular pair sold on eBay for $60. So those sold for, let's see, I had them listed for $100. Oh, they sold for $100. So somebody just bought these. So got those for $10 at the flea market. The brown pair sold for $100. The denim pair sold for $60, so that's not too shabby. Let's see. Candy picked up a pair of Grant Stone dress shoes or boots, whatever. They were new without the box. Paid up for those. Those were $40, but those sold for $125. I mean, I don't know how many times I got to say Candy knows what the hell she's doing, but that's kind of proof right there. So few videos back, you saw that we picked up some beer mirrors for, like, you know, man cave or a bar or whatever. One of those was a light up, a vintage Coors beer lighted mirror. And I paid $23 for those at the Habitat for Humanity. Another piece that sold, this has all been within the last 3 weeks, I guess. And within the last week, we've just had a crazy, it's been bananas. I was kind of surprised, being it was Thanksgiving week, Thursday and Friday, the long weekend and so forth, but it's just been bananas. A Benjamin Miracord record player, vintage record player made in Germany. I think Candy got this at this was an estate sale. $70.56 she paid for that. That sold for $150 plus shipping. Now, the shipping was kind of funny on this one. And, you know, every once in a while, I'm sure you resellers run into this also. And if you give a shit about the people that you sell to, you tend to kind of take these stories to heart. But this one had a really interesting backstory, and the guy had messaged us, and apparently this was his grandfather's company, and he's been searching high and low for one of these turntables. So added pressure to box it up, but his message to us was, I don't care what it costs to ship, I want this, so on and so forth. So to the gentleman that purchased this, I hope you enjoy it, and honestly, I hope it reaches you in good condition. We just shipped it out. Actually, it's been a little while. You should be receiving it any time now. So it's, those are really cool backstories. And the same with the Etsy sale I'll go into after this. There's a cool, kind of a cool backstory on this. Let's see here. I think this was kind of an arbitrage thing. Candy went to Marshall's the other day, picked up a, this is a Nicole Miller a Christmas tree decorative throw blanket. She paid $24.99 plus tax for that. And it sold for $55 plus shipping. Now, here's kind of another funny story. I was looking for, I have all kinds of stereo shit in my kind of half-assed studio in the garage where I have my drums and everything else, and I can practice out there. But right now, all my stuff that for like touring and gigging and all that stuff is all stacked, and I got rid of my sound studio. So everything's in the garage, and it's kind of hard for me to access all that, that area right there. And it's been, you know, winter and holiday, so I don't go out there as much right now. But anyway, we got some a sound bar and some surround sound stuff, and I was like, well, how the hell am I going to test this? I need a tuner. So I was looking for a cheap tuner. We hit a couple of estate sales, garage sales, so on and so forth. Everybody kind of wanted 50, 60 bucks. Well, I found one on Facebook Marketplace, but it had speakers and everything else. And the guy wanted 40 bucks for the whole thing. And I was like, he's in the town next to us. I'm like, dude, I'm on my way. So I went up, picked it up just for the tuner. I just needed the tuner. But I did notice in his listing that there was a pair of Serwin Vega desktop speakers. And I was like, those are good. So I went up there, gave him $40, bought all this stuff. So anyway, long story short, I just need the tuner. I kept the tuner and I tested all the sound stuff where that's all listed. But I was like, I don't need these speakers. So listed them, a pair of Serwin Vega L7 shelf desktop speakers, beautiful condition. The grills were in perfect condition. Everything else, sold those for $80. So after I, he had two pairs of speakers, the tuner, and a DVD player. So after averaging everything out, it was $11. I figured I paid for each component, $11.25. Sold those for $80 plus shipping. So there you go. Got twice our money back, and we're still using the tuner. let's see here. Keep going here. Another arbitrage thing, just to kind of show you, we don't try and pigeonhole ourselves as just resellers or just, you know, we try to get something from everywhere and we're always on the hunt for it, whether it's arbitrage, whether it's online auctions, which we enjoy, whether it's estate sales or flea markets or garage sales. We like it all, man. It doesn't matter. A pair of shiny brights, Christmas ornaments, and somebody bought both boxes. So we, Candy bought two boxes for $14. Somebody bought both boxes for $59.98 because Candy offered a 10% discount on there when you bought more than one, and they did, they bought both. So that was pretty good. A John Deere pullover hoodie, which was green. We've had this for quite some time. We picked this up for 87 cents at a garage sale, and it finally sold for $24.99. Let's see here. Pair of Dickies pants, blue corduroys. We paid $3.33 at a garage sale in Vacaville. That's our town. That's where we live. Those sold for $24.99. A Mr. Christmas Santa's marching band. Candy got that at an estate sale for $15. And that sold for $99.99. This is a significant sale only in the fact that it has a really cool backstory. And I don't know all of it because I didn't read all the messages, but it basically boils down to a parent had this same plush, and we don't buy a lot of plushes, but some of, you know, sometimes we grab them. This is a vintage 1985 Mattel bunny rabbit. 17 inches tall. And essentially their story was they had one when they were a child and they were hoping to pass it along to their kid. And something happened. They don't have it anymore. And they found ours on eBay and we're happy that it's the exact same one. So, we paid $1.66 for that in an online auction and that sold for $7.99 plus shipping. A pair of Doc Martens that we picked up at the Napa flea market. I don't think this last time, maybe the time before, maybe it was this last time. I don't know. I don't remember. Paid $20 for those and those sold for $49.99. One of the Transformers that I got in online auction, we paid $13.37. I think I told you there was kind of this bidding war on these Transformers that were new in box. One of those already sold for $69.99. So that paid for the whole lot. I think I paid $63 for a lot of six of them. So this one paid for the whole lot. The rest of them are just profit, pure profit at this point, which is good because I gave two of them to our little nephews last night when they came they're really into these things. So we, you know, share the love, I guess. One of the, so this was a pretty cool one. Several months ago, Candy got a Ralph Lauren, kind of like a whiskey glass, crystal whiskey glass. I had no idea they made them. She paid 99 cents at a Goodwill for the, and this one sold for $44.99. Now, one of the smoking pipes that you saw that I got in the online auction this past time, it was in a lot of, I think there's four, five, six, seven pipes all together, and then like a little caddy that's got a holder for, it's right here, I gotta post the rest, but it's got a holder for the tobacco and so on and so forth. So I don't remember what I paid for that whole thing. It was like 70. Let me see if I can find the invoice right here real quick. Anyway, it was, let's see here, pipe bundle. $71.30 I paid for the whole thing. That was all of the pipes and the little caddy. And one of those already sold. I had it listed for, I think, $100, and I took an offer for $70. So, you know, we paid $17.83 for that one pipe. It's kind of cool. It's hand-carved, lion head, so on and so forth. Anyway, $70. Sorry, I was peeking at the football game there to see the score. let's see. A large Dooney and Burke tote sold. We got that for $5. In North Highlands a few weeks back. That sold for $37.88. My cowboy hat that you saw in a couple of videos back, I was modeling it on the thumbnail there. That was a Stetson 4XB vintage cowboy hat. That we paid $16.10 for in an online auction. That sold for $70 within like, I don't know, maybe a couple of days of posting it. A lapel microphone, Audio Technica lapel microphone. We got that quite a while ago at an online auction. We paid $3.23 for it. It was in a bunch of other musical stuff. That sold for $69. That was new in package. And here are a couple of the things that have just sold within the last few days. One of our Garmins that we picked up in a garage sale a few weeks ago, we paid $10 for that. That sold for $34.99. Let's see, a Coach scarf that we picked up. Doesn't say how much, so I don't know. It wasn't very much at all, if anything. We hit a garage sale not too long ago, and we're trying to buy stuff, and the girl was like, oh no, I feel so bad charging, just take it. So that sold for $17.99. One of the G.I. Joes that I picked up in that same online auction sold. I paid $25.37 for that. That was in a bundle, I think, of two G.I. Joes. One of them, when I got it here to the house, I realized it wasn't complete. It still has the box and everything. It'll sell, but it's missing a couple of the little pieces that are inside, like his shovel or whatever. This one was complete, in box, brand new. And we paid $25.37 for this, and it sold for $44.99. So that paid for the lot, so we're not going to lose any money on that lot, but the other one will go for less, so we're not going to make as much profit on that lot as we originally thought, but that's okay. Anyway, let's move along here. That's really it. Everything's not a Tascam. Audio interface that I picked up a couple of weeks ago at this was the Concord flea market for $20. That sold for $38. We have another one still. I took an offer on that. We have one more available, and that's it, really. My chickens are going crazy in the back for some reason. So then, like I said, you saw the Poshmark sale, and then on top of that, Candy's Etsy sale, which was $499.99, which was just bananas. So it's been a really good month, I think. I don't go through all the analytics and all that in the back office and do all that, but it just feels like it's been a really good month. A lot of stuff has sold. Hope you guys all had a great Thanksgiving, got to spend some time with some family and friends, had some good drink, had some good food. We smoked a turkey here.
Long, I come home, I want a little smoked turkey.
Did a ham, so we have leftovers for days. Everything was delicious and great. We had all the family members here at our house. So it was really cool. And it's just been a really good week to kind of hang out with our family and friends and stuff. To all of you, hope the same. Hope you guys all had a great Thanksgiving. Looking forward to Christmas coming up. So there'll be a few more videos before Christmas, I hope. We got to go through our death pile and get things in order here, because it's becoming an eyesore. Maybe I'll show that to you next time.